There's a big challenge when you're a farm family in particular, because your cash flow can fluctuate quite violently, especially if you have the kind of income that comes in, you know, once a season or once a year, once a quarter. Of course, there are those types of farms that come in and have income coming in more regularly, but that doesn't mean you can't plan regularly. And so one of the smartest things a farm family can do is learn to carve off a little bit every month that they decide is family income, that they have an, I would recommend, automated movement from one account to the other, that they spend the family money out of the one account that not connected to the farm. And I would suggest that people look at, you know, those expenses that they've got coming out of the farm and try and weed out what's really a farm expense and what is more household expense, and try and get those things separated. Because one of the more dangerous things we tend to do is keep things too commingled, and then we can't see anything. And then kind of like the budgeting issue, our brains get tired and we just do whatever. So if you find yourself where you're in your season that cash is rolling in, that's the best time to start giving yourself an income. But that's not always possible. You might be, you know, 6 or 9 months from that right now when you're watching this. So look at the stores of cash that you have today and the access to capital that you have today, and see if there's still a way to generate a farm income. Because then when that money comes in your season next, you can pay off some of those debts that you might have had to use up, like a line of credit or something. But you will stabilize your spending if you do it that way. You're way less likely to overspend on the personal things, and then you're more likely to make those resources last, and then you get in the habit of that. Because one of the really dangerous things we see people do who have very volatile incomes or infrequent incomes is when things are tough, the debt starts racking up a little bit and a little bit and a little bit and a little bit more, and it feels awful. And then we get a big check, we get a big deposit. We're like, oh, thank goodness, it's over, yay. But then we hesitate to go pay down all the debt we racked up in the off season, because just in case, we don't wanna feel like that again. We don't wanna deplete the cash store by paying back the debt. Problem with that is every time, every season, the debt racks up a little bit more and a little bit more, and all of a sudden you can't qualify to buy the thing that you really need. You can't get those extra 20 cows. You can't buy the new combine because you can't afford it because that other debt has racked up. So really look for opportunities to parse off family farm income and stick to it even when it's hard.